This video will show you how to install Mac OSX 10.8 Mountain Lion to a external hard drive. This is the one I'll be using. It's a Samsung SSD. It'll work with any hard drive though. For those of you that are wondering, it's the 840 Pro, 128 gig. You're going to need some kind of enclosure or a case to hook it up to your computer. This is just what I got. It's like $15 from Fry's. Got that, plugs in right to the ports on the SSD. So once you got that in there, just plug the USB into there. Make sure when you get the case it says USB 3.0 also. And then on the side of your computer, wherever your USB port is, plug it into there as well. If it's the first time you're using the drive, when you turn it on, it's going to say this drive was not recognizable. It'll say initialize, so you want to click initialize, which that will just take you to disk utility. If you don't know how to get there, click the launch pad, click other, disk utility. Then you want to select it from the side. Select it, go to erase. Make sure it's on format Mac OS Extended Journaled. You can name it whatever you want. Then hit erase, confirm. Okay, so once that's done, you're gonna need a install disk, or install drive, since they don't sell Mountain Lion on a CD. It's the only downloadable. You can put it onto a USB drive and then turn it into an install drive so it acts like a CD once you plug it into the USB import or input. If you don't know how to do that, click this link now and it'll take you to my other video that shows you how to do that. So what you do is just plug this into another one of your free USB ports that are open. Give it a second, it'll load up. Click install Mountain Lion. Continue. Agree. Agree. So it doesn't show your hard drive right now. You want to click show all disks, and I know this is it right here because that's the USB drive I just plugged in. So this is what I want to install it to. So highlight it, click install. Enter your system password, press enter, and it will do your thing. It might come up with a prompt saying plug your computer into a power outlet. You don't have to if you got a full battery. If not, you might want to if you're about halfway done. Notice there it says 50 hours and 8 minutes remaining. That's really not the case. In a couple seconds here it's going to drop down to about 7 minutes and it'll restart. And we'll come back once it's done installing. I'll show you the rest. Alright, so that took about 6 minutes. Then it'll say click to restart. So you want to hit restart. Close other applications if you have any open. Okay, so it says it's going to take about 20 minutes to install. I'll come back when it's done. Alright, so once it's done installing, it's going to boot up from the device that you installed it on. So right now it's running off of my external hard drive that I installed it to. So you gotta set it up just as if it's the first time you're turning on your computer. So at this point, if you want, you can import stuff from your computer's hard drive or from another computer. I'm not going to do it, not now. Alright, so you probably really don't want to watch me set up everything, but that's how you do it. And if you want to boot back to your other, your hard drive that's in your computer, what you do is when you restart your computer and the gray screen comes up, hold down the Option key. It's right next to the space bar and the Command key. Just hold it down for about, I don't know, 5-10 seconds. And it will pop up with everything that you can boot your computer from. So this is my original, or no, this one. No, it's this one. This is the hard drive that's inside of my computer. There you go.